Penguin Random House Audio presents Reclaiming Body Trust, A Path to Healing and Liberation by Hilary Kinavey, MS, LPC, and Dana Sturtevant, MS, RD. Read for you by Hilary Kinavey with Jessica Almasy, Eileen Stevens, Angela Braxton-Johnson, and Nicky Endres. We dedicate this book to those whose body stories, pain, and lived experiences have been disregarded and disbelieved, and to the people who have lost their lives due to systemic and interpersonal weight stigma. We also dedicate this book to Kyan and Luca and all the children in the world for whom we wish to preserve body trust. May they always feel at home in and have reverence for their bodies. I am a person reclaiming body trust. I am reclaiming trust in my body. My hunger, my appetites, my longings, my skin, my bones, my size are mine for the taking. I take back my voice, my agency, my worthiness, my belonging in the world of beautiful and diverse beings. I live without apology for the straight lines and curves, living tissue and vulnerable heart, that hold my living, breathing, manifested story. I feel where my body begins, and I protect where it ends. The marketing, the expectations, the gaze of the other belong outside of me and are not for my internalization. I will no longer ingest the external and make it my goal or my standard. I will not trade my right to express my freedom, my dreams, my needs, my wants, or my beauty. I listen for my appetites, all of them. I say yes, I say no, and I say not now. My body is wise, it knows me, it is me, I am it. My body is not an expression of gluttony or neglect, nor is it ugly. My body is an expression of life and of being alive. It is my companion for this unfolding story, replete with unexpected bumps and grooves, loves and losses. And as such, my body expresses my story with its textures, rolls, shapes, peaks, and valleys. I will not betray you, body, for an endless diet or self-improvement project. I will not confuse thinness for health. I will no longer objectify myself, nor will I continue to invest in oppressive beauty standards. I am a person reclaiming my movement, my rhythm, my flow. I seek satisfaction and explore pleasure. I value my inner peace, my self-worth, more than the approval of outside stigma and hate-inflicting eyes. I will count myself among the millions of people who have come before me in their struggles to live compassionately in the bodies they have. And I will also count myself among the millions to come who will reclaim their body and rebuild that trust. I'm not alone on the path. In fact, I am helping to transition the world with my courage, my fierceness, my bold and beautiful body. Introduction. What has come between you and feeling at home in your body? How did you first come to learn that your body was a problem? These are some of the first questions we ask people who attend our workshops, retreats, online courses, and professional training. If you've picked up this audiobook, you've likely had a complicated relationship with your body. One that has led to years of body loathing and distrust, weighing and measuring, cycling through plan after restrictive plan, and feeling out of control and frustrated about your food and your body. You've likely tried a lot of different things along the way to feel in control. And the hustle created by this lifelong body project has left you feeling exhausted, angry, and unable to trust yourself. You may notice how your tolerance to food restriction and dietary restraint has diminished over time, that the plans you were once able to follow for months, even years, now last a couple of days if you're lucky. And any weight you may have lost on these plans has been regained plus more. You may feel at a loss for what to do next. You've tried so hard for so long and nothing seems to work. You may not believe us when we tell you that none of this is your fault. You are not broken. We promise there does not need to be a separate set of rules for you. But you may want to try something different instead of just trying harder. Curious? If what we've shared so far is resonating, this book may be exactly what you need to get out of the endless cycle of shame and body blame. The truth. Efforts to lose weight disconnect you from your body's wisdom. The $71 billion diet and weight industry thrives because nobody blames its plans when you can no longer sustain them. You blame yourself, and you believe you have no willpower, that you can't be trusted with food, and that you're addicted. So you return to these so-called experts to tell you what to do. Here's another truth. These are experts in ideologies and a failed weight loss paradigm. There is no evidence-based treatment for weight that leads to sustained weight loss. In a meta-analysis of 29 studies on structured weight loss programs conducted in the United States, found that participants regained 77% of their initial weight loss on average after 5 years. No program has ever demonstrated long-term maintenance of weight loss for any but a small minority. We've basically been duped. We've been socialized and indoctrinated into oppressive and mechanistic ways of thinking about the body before we are old enough to consent. Most people who have worked with us acknowledge that they learned something was wrong with their body before the age of 10, and many much earlier. As we age, we spend more time thinking about the body than being in the body. We believe that the body must be tightly controlled, that thin equals healthy, that one meal or day of eating has the power to heal or kill us, and that all we have to do is get this calories in versus out equation right. It is an oppressive, inauthentic, and unsustainable way to occupy and care for a body. The act of reclaiming body trust is both personal and political. We struggle as a society to understand the role discrimination, stigma, and oppression have played in the emotional and physical well-being of people with marginalized identities. We fail to see how our conversations about well-being have often bypassed the social determinants of health, poverty, trauma, environmental racism, genetics, etc. We over-rely on personal responsibility and bootstrapping rhetoric. For example, if you get sick, it's because you aren't living a healthy lifestyle. We reinforce a hierarchy of bodies that is upheld across systems and institutions without questioning the validity of our knowing. An individual's worthiness is born from this, as well as the coping mechanisms that allow people to survive in a culture that doesn't truly value them. This book is about where and why that coping began, how it evolved, and how we begin to feel more free. We are a therapist-dietitian team who co-founded the Center for Body Trust to help people heal from the effects of living in a weight and health-obsessed world. We started our work together more than 17 years ago, after witnessing the harm caused by nutrition ideologies, toxic fitness culture, and the traditional weight loss paradigm. We saw an urgent need to have different conversations with people about food, their bodies, their weight, their health, and their well-being. Our body trust framework has evolved over time with our own learning and unlearning as two white, cisgendered, currently able-bodied women who've had our own complicated relationships with our bodies. Because we cannot speak to all readers' lived experience, we have included stories and sourced the wisdom and expertise of others throughout this book to offer more perspectives. We've done our best, with the support and guidance from our teachers and mentors, to situate our work in liberatory frameworks and methodologies. Body trust is scientifically grounded and greatly informed by the following: Bobby Harrow's cycle of socialization and cycle of liberation, Barbara Love's liberatory consciousness, Desiree Attaway's praxis of liberation, Neva Perron's developmental theory of embodiment, and health at every size principles, as well as intuitive eating principles, shame resilience theory, motivational interviewing, self-compassion theory, feminist therapies, mindfulness-based approaches, and postmodern therapeutic thought. Dana has deep roots in the American Midwest and grew up solidly middle class in ex-urban Chicago. When she was 16, her family moved to Miami, Florida, and a whole new world opened in terms of culture and diversity. Dana has a Norwegian and German heritage, is currently a size 16-18, and her body story includes weight teasing by high school friends, chronic pain, an autoimmune condition, and a 4-year struggle with infertility. Dana completed both her bachelor's and master's degree in nutrition science. Her training as a registered dietitian was steeped in the dominant weight paradigm, and 10 years of her career was focusing on helping people lose weight and keep it off. 7 as a research interventionist, and 3 as a bariatric dietitian. Like many healthcare providers, Dana believed she was promoting healthy lifestyles at the time, not dieting behaviors. As she became more skeptical of the advice she was giving and feared she was causing more harm than good, she discovered a growing community of helping professionals offering alternatives to the traditional way she'd been trained to think about food, weight, and health. Feeling unethical in her work and knowing that...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.